Hi there, guys. Al the Doctor Who. I'm making a video vlog on YouTube. I used to make a lot of vlogs on a social network site called Vloggerheads. And recently, people have been using the term VH. It was fun, you know, and I'm really not here to talk about VH, but what I really wanted to talk about was events that have occurred in my life. And the reason why I'm bringing this particular topic up is because I have a friend who is going through something at this point. And, you know, anytime I hear somebody speak about, trials and tribulations of our life, I start to analyze it from my perspective, from the things that I've witnessed in my life. And I noticed that there are a lot of similarities. And it's interesting to see that the reactions that we get are pretty much the same. So really, we really react just as a human should react. But let me put it this way. First of all, I have to tell you how my mindset is. I'm dyslexic, as most of you know already. And so I see things the way this fiber optic cable would see things in my mind. There's a lot of information that goes through this, but the mind itself is not capable of dispersing the imagery that you get from this cable. Although I see it that way. In fact, I have a visual view on everything in my mind, and I've been working with that from day one, as far back as I can remember. And I felt bad for this friend that I have on the internet, mainly because she's having a rough time accepting the passing of her mother. And I can only relate to that because I've seen this. It happened to me, and it happened to me in my midlife. Well, when I say midlife, I mean the middle of it happened to me when I was 31. I accepted my mother's death, and it was easy for me because she was suffering a lot. And from my past experiences, because I've witnessed deaths many times before this, and those first initial deaths were hard for me to accept, but they were a learning thing for me. It's heart-wrenching, the first one, that's the same thing with everything in life. Your first love, you know, your first everything, the first time you do anything is the biggest hurdle, and then after that it becomes simpler and simpler. Now, I'm not saying that death is is simple to accept at any time, but I remember when my father passed, it was really a very, very, very sad thing because, you know, they gave him a pacemaker, you know, they did everything to assure that he would live long and suffered a great deal. I mean, it's just terrible. But I learned something from the passing of my cat, believe it or not. I seen how selfish I was to keep this cat alive. And then when the cat finally died, I had learned a very important lesson. And that was to let your loved one go. Let the loved one go. If you love something, let it go. You know what I mean? It's going to hurt. It's going to hurt like hell. But you got to let it go. The only thing you can really do is appreciate the fact that they were here and that they offered some sort of something to you. You know what I'm saying? And that's about it. That's about all you can say. You know, just like they say, count your blessings. It's really what it comes down to. And, you know, I remember my father told me he was going to fight. And then one day he just said to me, "Let me go." And I says, I didn't think I'd see that ever. But he really believed in the medicine, and you know, the doctors kept you alive when you're a merchant marine, but when you're a civilian, You're a statistic. What drug works on you? What drug doesn't work on you? It's really a statistic now. Everything has become statistics. Anyway, I'm not going to keep you guys long. That's my vlog. Try to for you guys that are running into the same situation, just try to use it as a learning tool. Losing anyone close to you is rough, but what can I tell you? You have to try and just turn a negative into a positive. That's about the best thing I could say. And I should listen to my own advice. I'll catch you guys later. Love yous all.